Hello everyone, welcome to my motovlog channel. This is Karthik, another tuning in. Now it's been raining a lot these days in Mumbai, so I'm not able to do any vlogs or something, and also I'm just kind of busy with the college thing, but I'll try my best to bring something really good to you guys, some kind of rides or something. But let's not focus on that, and let's just focus. Wait, am I on focus? Yes, I'm on focus. Okay, so let's just focus on today's topic, which is about my love and hate relationship with my helmets. Now, if you have been following me from the start, you know that I own two helmets. One is my Steelbud Air, which I usually use when I go on rides, like on highways and stuff. And my Royal Enfield open face helmet with a bubble visor, which I usually use when I... Kuch tha? Anyways, which I usually use when I go on city rides. Now, both of these helmets have its own flaws and its own, I can say, beauties, like pros and cons. So each one of them has their own pros and cons. So you can say that this is a kind of a review, a comprehensive review, you can say. So let's get started. Okay, so I start with my bubble visor, my Royal Enfield open face helmet. Now I got this helmet for 3000 bucks, and it had this clear visor. It didn't have this visor. I got this visor from this is an aftermarket visor. I'll talk about it, but first of all, this is a Royal Enfield helmet. Now the pros about this helmet is that it gives good airflow. It very comfortable. The padding, as you can see, the paddings are really really soft, and they are kind of even tight even after using it so much, and even after putting them into washing machine and washing them, they didn't squish or shrunk or something. They are really really good. I'm really good happy with it. Also the quality, it gives you the feeling of protection, and it's really kind of not that heavy but not even that light, so you feel protected, and it's really good for the quality amount of money you are paying. Now talking about the cons. Now the cons are, well, there are not much of the cons, but if you kind of, you know, actually to be honest, there are no cons with this helmet. No, I'm not paid by Royal Enfield, of course, because I had to pay for this helmet. Yeah, the only con about this helmet was that MLG, I don't know if you can see it. So as you can see, there was MLG written here. MLG 1901, but I scraped it because I'm customizing this helmet. Now why did I scrape it? Because the thing is, when this helmet was with me, it was not printed, it was painted, like it was kind of painted. So I was using this helmet, and slowly the paint was coming out. So from MLG 1901 it went to MLG 190, like the one vanished. So, and it looked kind of, you know, ugly, I can say, because some of the paint chips were coming off, and it was not tidy. So I decided to peel it all off. Now I'm still thinking what customization I can do with this helmet. So if you guys any suggestion, you can comment down below. And I'm still thinking to paint, like, you know, put a sticker on this, the same MLG one, along with some other stickers which I'll customize or get from the internet. And if you can see, I kept the Royal Enfield logo because it looks kind of cool on it, so I didn't scrape it. And if you can see closely, it is not sticked, it is painted, so it's not just printed. Now the helmets which they provide now has printed already on it, so it's good. And technically this is a, where did that went? Okay, I can't find it. Well, technically this is a Vega helmet. I don't remember the model name, but this is a Vega helmet produced under the name of Royal Enfield. So you get a beautiful Vega helmet in the name of Royal Enfield. But if you don't want to go for this, there are many such Desert Storm colors open face helmet you can get. I'll really suggest THH because they have very good padding, which is thicker than this, and it looks really comfortable. I tried it and it's really comfortable. So you can go for this if you don't want the Royal Enfield one. Now we are done with this. Now moving on to the Steelbud helmet. So here it is, the Steelbud helmet. Now I got this helmet for 1700 bucks. Now the amount of money I paid for this helmet is enough, because this helmet has been good. This is my first full face helmet. Now I have been really familiar with open face helmet. I have never tried full face helmet. So and when I tried this first, it was kind of awkward because I was not able to see what's underneath me. You can understand, like, this thing comes, so it gets awkward. You can see everything, but still I had a tendency of watching the whole dashboard and things. So but with this I was not able to, that, you know, it was not that visible, like what's on my bike and things, though it's not necessary, but still. But this helmet is best if you are not at all familiar with open full face helmet, because unlike other full face helmets like LS2 THH, they have this thick padding, like really really thick padding, so it gets too tight. Sometimes it gets suffocating if you are someone who can't adjust with that kind of thing. So what I'll suggest is go for a Steelbird Air helmet. It has not that thick padding, but a really thin padding. So what it is, that it keeps you comfortable, you can easily move your head around. It does not get that tight, but it is not that loose. Now that is the best thing about it, because this thing is really giving me the familiarity of full face. Okay, I'm not in focus, shit. Okay, so this thing gives me the familiarity of having a full face helmet. After wearing this for a long time, I am now kind of ready to go on to LS2 or THH with a chin guard and thick padding, because I think it will be comfortable for me. Now looking at the cons. Now the cons of this helmet is the padding is really thin. Now I know you'll be like, ye double dholki kyun ban raha hai? Mumbai cars will understand what did I just say. So the thing is that the padding are really thin, like literally thin. At least I expected this much, as you can see, at least I expected this much, but it's only this much. And this was the last thickest padding they had for Steelbird. So I'm kind of not okay with it. Also, the gap between your chin and this thing is too much. So there is lots of airflow inside. Also, it moves a lot. Like even if someone bangs you, it will move a lot. And I used to have long hair, as I said before, and I used to tie a bun before wearing a helmet. So before, this helmet used to get tight a lot, but now when I got short hair, this helmet is loose. But thanks to my bandana, I don't know where it is, thanks to my bandana, I can now easily fit in this helmet. So that's the con, that the padding is really thin and there is no chin guard. But I can understand that this, I can say, a beginner's helmet, beginner's full face helmet, so it is good. Regarding the graphic and thing, yeah, it's cool, but I already customized it with lots and lots of stickers, as you can see, it's all over. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So I hope you all enjoyed the video. I know it was kind of boring, but I seriously have nothing to show you guys, because it's just raining. There's nothing I can do in this Mumbai right now. But I'll be soon going somewhere, because even I'm getting homesick. So I'll be soon going out somewhere and I'll be taking you guys with me. So till that time, if you all like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Do comment down below if any queries, any question, or any suggestion for my open face helmet customization, because I really don't know what to do. So I'm just getting confused. If you have any suggestion, do comment down below. Be free to comment down below. Also, do share it among your friends. If they are, you know, want to buy a helmet or are confused with buying a helmet, do share it among your friends, help them out. And if you are new, if you're watching me for the first time, the subscribe button must be somewhere there. Just hit it and be entertained. Yeah. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I really need a ending dialogue, because every time I get stuck here, I do need an ending dialogue. So anyways, till that time, stay happy and achieve your goals. Do what you want. Have fun with life. Ride hard, ride safe. And I will see you next time. Is it recording? Oh, okay, it's recording.